Over the past few days, we've seen record cases of COVID-19 across the country, and it's a cause for concern. Behind each new number is a friend, a parent, a neighbor, or a senior. People's lives are at stake, and we all need to do our part. So follow your local public health guidelines, wear a mask, and keep a safe 2-meter distance from one another. Download the COVID Alert app. It's easy, it's free, and with over 4.8 million downloads, it'll help you do your part to protect your friends and loved ones. Together, we will get through this. Au cours des derniers jours, nous avons enregistré des nombres records de cas de COVID-19 un peu partout au pays. La situation est inquiétante, et il faut la prendre au sérieux. Chaque nouveau cas, c'est pas seulement un chiffre ou une statistique, c'est un ami, un membre de notre famille, un voisin ou une personne âgée. Quand la vie des gens est en jeu, il est important de tous faire notre part. Continuez de suivre les directives locales de santé publique, portez un masque, respectez la distance sécuritaire de 2 mètres et téléchargez l'application gratuite Alerte COVID. Since the pandemic started, many folks have found themselves working from home. And in cases where they've needed to self-isolate, most Canadians have been able to do so because they have a roof over their heads. But imagine if you didn't have a home, especially during a Canadian winter. Sadly, that's the reality for far too many Canadians, and our government is taking action to change that. Since 2015, we've created a national strategy to make housing a priority, with thousands of units constructed and provided affordable housing for over 1 million people. We took this issue seriously since forming government, and now that the pandemic has made housing needs more acute, we're stepping up again. Last month, Minister Hussein announced an investment of $1 billion for the new Rapid Housing Initiative. The goal of the program is to give the most vulnerable a safe place to live by quickly creating up to 3,000 new affordable housing units. Today, I can share more details about how this funding will be used. The Rapid Housing Initiative will be equally split between the major cities stream and the projects stream. Right now, our largest cities face a growing need for safe and affordable housing. We're investing $500 million for immediate support to build long-term housing for municipalities that have the highest demand. We've also opened up applications for the second half of funding through the projects stream. Today's announcement is part of our commitment to eliminate chronic homelessness in Canada, as we announced in the throne speech, while also creating good jobs in the housing and construction sectors. Aujourd'hui, j'annonce que notre plan d'$1 milliard pour soutenir les Canadiens vulnérables dans le cadre de l'initiative pour la création rapide de logements sera divisé en 2 volets, le volet grande ville et le volet projet. En ce moment, nos plus grandes villes font face à une demande croissante pour des logements sûrs et abordables. Nous investissons donc $500 millions dans l'aide immédiate à la construction de logements à long terme pour les municipalités où la demande est la plus forte. La deuxième moitié du montant ira pour le volet projet, qui acceptera des demandes pour les municipalités, les provinces et les territoires, ainsi que pour les organisations sans but lucratif et les corps dirigeants autochtones. L'annonce d'aujourd'hui s'inscrit dans notre engagement à éliminer l'itinérance chronique au Canada, comme nous l'avons annoncé dans le discours du trône, tout en créant de bons emplois dans les secteurs du logement et de la construction. Canada is now in the second wave of this pandemic. That comes with new challenges for small business owners. And as I told the Canadian Chamber of Commerce yesterday, we're stepping up to help, as we have since day one. Earlier this month, we announced that we would strengthen the programs that have been a lifeline for small businesses by introducing an extended wage subsidy, which covers up to 65% of eligible wages. Business owners like Steve and Cammy of Steve's Poke Bar in BC will be able to keep their employees on the payroll. For support on rent, the new Canada Emergency Rent Subsidy will go directly to businesses not to landlords. And those who have to close temporarily because of a local public health order will be eligible for an additional 25% support. That brings the total of 90% of rent covered for the hardest hit businesses. And to help cover other costs, we've expanded the eligibility for the Canada Emergency Business Account while increasing the total amount to $60,000. Depuis hier, les entreprises qui exercent leurs activités à partir de comptes bancaires personnels ont maintenant accès aux prêts accordés dans le cadre du compte d'urgence pour entreprises canadiennes en ouvrant un compte commercial auprès d'une institution financière participante. En ce qui concerne les autres mesures, comme la subvention salariale et la subvention pour le loyer, on va déposer un projet de loi sous peu. J'espère que tous les députés de la Chambre des communes se joindront à nous pour adopter cette mesure d'aide cruciale pour les entreprises canadiennes. I'd like to end this morning by taking a moment to recognize all of the women and men across the country who keep Canadians fed. Our government is here to support them just like we have been since the start of the pandemic. Today, Minister Bibeau will outline how people in BC can apply for the Emergency On-Farm Support Fund. People in other provinces will also be able to apply soon. Le Fonds d'urgence pour les mesures de soutien à la ferme de 35 millions de dollars est déployé province par province pour aider les exploitants agricoles et assurer la santé et la sécurité des travailleurs agricoles d'ensemble du pays. La ministre Bibeau va en parler plus longuement plus tard aujourd'hui. Mais on va continuer de faire notre part afin de soutenir les gens qui travaillent fort pour nous permettre de nourrir nos familles.